Jazz at any time.
Yeah, it's me, Wario. I'm Mega Noin.
I'm also Wario.
I'm also Wario.
A lot of vocal fry on Wario, more than I remember there being.
Mario.
This is Mario Party 10, and taking a beautiful snapshot of Toad and his best friend Waluigi, just to sort of set the stage.
Yeah, we're coming to you live from, we've got a meeting in New York this week, so we're coming to you live from our recording studio, which is sitting in front of a couch looking at a laptop.
And it's going very well so far, I think.
We're sitting on the floor.
So far, it feels very viral, very fresh. Mario Party 10, what was the last Mario Party you played?
Is there a difference between them, or?
There's a pretty big difference, yeah.
I would have no way to know.
So if you've played Mario Party 9.
I might have, I don't know.
If you've played Mario Party 9, this is going to look very familiar. This is sort of the basic Mario Party setup. And what's different here, and what Mario Party 9 changed, that they've carried over in 10, is that all the characters are together in the same vehicle, so when you move, everybody moves.
That seems like a very smart idea.
Yeah, it sort of keeps everybody together at the same spot on the board, and then the idea is there are certain spots where if you pass through them, you get points for yourself, so the game becomes like moving so that you go through the good spots where you get points, and making other people go through the bad spots where
Doesn't
you lose
Doesn't that eliminate
points.
Like the 2v2, one-on-one kind of vibe that they
No,
have?
Because there is a random, whenever you land on a minigame block, like I just did, I just played a free-for-all minigame, it basically is like another dice that turns, that decides the teams for you. So this one is a 1v3. I'm playing as Spike, who's like the best character. He's got the best, time to kill, best accuracy.
No scopes.
In this mission, Daisy is controlling all the blue paddles while the other three players are on the red.
Who's frozen there steering?
What? That's
Frozen? That's Frozen?
Yeah, it's Frozen from the movie Frozen. So in Mario Party, like the basic Mario Party mode, kind of like it was in 9, the board is really long and has all these sort of special events on it. It's not like a lap thing. You just sort of do it one go and then you're done. And there are boss fights. So halfway through, you do a special boss mini game like this one where you have to stomp on the Goomba and whoever does it the most wins. Got that last hit, no scope, time to kill.
And we don't know which one of these was you.
I'm Spike. Okay. I'm the little goblin looking guy. The maps are bigger and they have a lot more character. Like this is an amusement park map, and so there are different spots where you can do different challenges if you land on the right place. And then
the mini games are themed to the map.
Right, and this isn't even technically a mini game. This is just like a thing that you do if you land on this spot on the map, and instead of like competing for like the set of mini games, you do these like cinematic events where you fly around on a roller coaster all around the map and try and jump to collect stars. It's probably the coolest thing about the mode, but ultimately there is still some randomization type stuff. So once your party has rolled all 6 of the numbers on the dice, Bowser comes and he just wrecks your shit like super, super harsh. He really harshes your mellow.
He looks angry.
This is one of the only ways that the gamepad is folded into the basic Mario Party mode, because the gamepad just shows a prison where Bowser's being kept in solitary confinement. And then the way you unlock the prison is once all 6 numbers on the die have been rolled, which, I don't know, if you're lucky, may not even happen by the time you get to the end of the map. If it happens really early, it gets hard, because not only does Bowser screw over the last player that lets him out, he changes the board and adds Bowser spots, which can get really rough. Here's a 2-on-2 game. That's actually one of the better games. One thing to keep in mind is when you're playing Mario Party just as one of the players, you only use the Wiimote, no nunchucks. So like the games are a little bit limited in that sense because it has fewer things. So this is a good strategic thing. I have a special dice block that's either a 1, 2, or 3, and I decided to roll that because I didn't want to go through this negative gate. But I rolled a 1 and I got picked up in a Bowser game. So that's another thing that they added in 9 that's sort of been carried over here too, is instead of items, there are special dice blocks. So there's like one that is only 4, 5, 6. Or one that's only 1s and 0s, which is kind of weird. And then there are special dice blocks that will let you roll very, very slowly. And trying to decide like which one to use to land on the most beneficial spot on the map is what you have to do. But the game is ultimately still very luck-based, because I landed on this and...
You got 64 stars.
Well, the challenge is that he took half of everybody's stars away. I had way more stars than everybody else. So, like, if I lose this challenge, I'm going to go from first place to last place guaranteed in the span of a single
challenge.
See,
that's not fun to me.
It's so quintessentially like Mario Party.
I mean,
Party.
It's very Mario Party, I guess. It just seems so random.
But at the same time, there's still an element of skill to it. Just don't lose this game. I've been playing for a few hours. I've played through a few matches, and I haven't run into anything that's like you land on a spot that's like steal all of this player's stars. Usually you have some level of agency in it. What's up? Spike's the boss.
Now, are all of the other characters, are these friends of yours? Or are these
This computers? is just, for recording purposes, I just did AI, for reasons I'll point out later. So at the end of the game, you also do this superstar ceremony, where they pick certain things to, like, give out bonus stars to. But it's random. So, like, congratulations, Peach and Rosalina, you moved the fewest number, or Daisy and Rosalina, you moved the fewest number of spaces, so you get 10 extra stars. So, like, that element of just, like, I haven't lost a game to this yet, but it could totally happen, and if it does, it's such a bummer, because you never know, like, which stars they're going to hand out at the end. It could be one where a player moves the fastest.
Gets is this the end of the board, or...?
That is the end of the board. There's another boss fight that you go through, but I didn't include it in the video.
Gotta keep something for the retail release. Right. Gotta keep some secrets.
So that's the basic Mario Party mode. I would say, like, in general, if you have played 9, it's pretty similar. The boards have a little bit more character, and I think that that's a cool addition. And if you haven't played a Mario Party game in a while, I think it kind of irons out a lot of the, like, annoyance factor. So this might be my favorite mode in the game. This is Bowser Party. Same sort of idea, except everybody in the car is participating. They're all cooperating, and Bowser just tries to murder all of them. So each player has 6 hit points. Well, they have 11 here because they've been doing very well. And you play, if Bowser catches you, everybody rolls and takes their turns, and they move the vehicle accordingly. And then Bowser rolls 4 dice, and if he catches you, you play a mini game where he tries to murder you. The best part is at certain points in the map, you get these decision points where Bowser knows what's up and the other players don't, and then draws on the screen to try and mess with them. So, like, circle this treasure chest if you want a player to pick that, because some of them are good, some of them are bad. So it's, like, trying to trick them into doing the wrong thing. Only this is all AI, so I don't even think they can read it when I write die on the screen. I don't think they even understand the concept
they
of
They don't
that.
Understand love. I don't know why they don't understand
They don't understand it when I write on the
Sonic
screen Sonic rules.
Right.
So yeah, that's like a fun element when you're playing with other people. The reason I played by myself is because you can't see what's going on the screen while I was capturing, so I had to play solo. But yeah, they picked the bad route. And they're actually going to give me an extra dice to try and catch up with them.
Are you Bowser? So a player is playing Bowser?
Yeah. One player plays Bowser, and they have the gamepad. So that is like the only sort of significant usage of the gamepad in the whole game, which is kind of weird. Like, I don't know. It is... For the most part, just kind of a set piece. You use it a bit in Amiibo Party, which is the next mode that I'll get to. But Bowser Party, I actually think I like the best of all the stuff I've played, just because, like, I don't know, the cooperative element is kind of fun, and the asymmetrical element is kind of cool. So this is a mode where all of the Bowser games are built around, like, dealing as much damage to people as you possibly can, and the only way Bowser wins is if he kills everybody before the final, before they can reach the ending. So in this one, I'm putting bombs down on a roulette board.
Have you tried playing this with friends?
Sure. I think it was the basic Mario Party was just kind of confusing because a lot of people who were playing hadn't played a Mario Party game in a while, and it's just so different. But the Bowser Party game is, I don't know, I had a good time with it. So this is Amiibo Party. You can play it without, so you need at least one Amiibo to do Amiibo Party, but other players can play without.
No, they don't let grown-ups buy Amiibos though, right? You have to be a little kid to buy them.
Yes, yeah, you have to go to the KB toy store and pick them up there. It's kind of a neat idea. There's some stuff that's kind of silly. The board is Luigi's board. I put it down by putting my amiibo on the board whenever we were picking it. My Luigi amiibo is equipped with a special token that I unlocked that gives him the pipe power-up. You can use it once per match, and it makes everybody switch places. So you decide that before you start going. You, like, load them out with one of those special tokens and a base. You can see that coin base is something I unlocked.
You also got him the stinger missiles, the heat vision goggles.
You got the heat vision goggles, yeah.
And a clob.
What's weird about amiibo party is in order to roll the dice, you actually touch your amiibo to the gamepad and then pick it up. Almost like you're flicking something, kind of like you're flicking a dice, which is okay, except like the rest of the time you're using your Wiimote. So it's not like you're passing the gamepad around and using that to control everything. You're still using the gamepad. It's just to roll and decide the rolls of dice. You use your amiibo to put it down and flick it. And that's also how you like deploy power-ups. So it's like, I don't know, somebody knocked me over with the dice, which I didn't appreciate. I don't know, it's kind of, it's a neat idea, like having this loadout for your amiibo that you can use strategically. But I don't know, just having to like lean over and touch your amiibo to the gamepad every time you want to roll a dice just
seems... Are they 2D because you don't have those amiibos?
Yeah, I mean, I have a few amiibos. There's a special Super Mario set of amiibos that you can use with,
Now, can you not use, like, can I get Marth up in this?
You can't get Marth up in it. You can't get Meta Knight up in this party, which I know. I know, I'm disappointed too.
Marth wants to party. He's been through a lot.
Sure.
So much roar.
The mini games are like
just one party.
We don't have a lot of video left. The mini games they're kind of hit or miss. Like that one where you, at the beginning of the video, where I was trying to follow donuts wasn't especially great. But some of them are more successful than others. This one's kind of neat. It's like jump rope but with bees. So yeah, this is Mario Party 10. I'll have my review up hopefully later this week. But I wanted to do a video just showing what's in it because there's a lot of different modes.
Let Marth party.
Let Marth party. It's time.
Let Marth party.